Hello everyone. So in this video, I will be showing you how to add primary key constraint to an existing column in a table in MySQL. So I'm currently using MySQL Workbench and let's get started. So here I have created a table called as MyTable1. It has just two columns, R number and name. So if I just go and do select asterisk from MyTable1, I will be just getting the contents inside it. And these are like the contents. And we are going to do R number as the primary key, okay? But R number has like a null value. And even it has even a repeated value 1. So we need to like remove all those things and we need to add our syntax. Okay, and even if you go to put description of MyTable1, it says it hasn't got any constraints. Okay, it can be null and it hasn't got any other constraints. Okay, so now let's go and add a primary key constraint for R number column. So the syntax is alter table name, which is MyTable1. Add constraint, and here our constraint name is primary key. Just I will just move this primary key, and inside you need to just put a bracket and you need to put the name of our column, this R number. So this is it, and this alter table add constraint primary key, this can be in capital letters, which that's not going to be an issue, but this thing should match with your the name that you have specified earlier, okay, as well as the role column name. So this is syntax, and if I just now go and run this, okay, I'll be getting an error saying that invalid use of null value, because a primary key, if you're defining a column as a primary key, it should not have any null values in it. And as I told you earlier, I'm having an null value in it, okay. So it's present in the name having Ben, okay. So let me just go and delete that particular row. So for deleting that row, we need to go brown and just type delete from MyTable1 var class name equal to Ben within double quotes. Okay, so this will do the work, and now that particular row is deleted. Okay, that's fine, but even we are having like repeated one, okay. Actually, primary key should be unique for in a column, and I think we will be getting again that error. So if I just go and run it again, yes, we are getting an error because duplicate entry. So again, we need to delete that particular row which is having a duplicate. So we can delete or we can just update this 1 as 3. So in this case, I'm having both the like it's same, okay. So let me just go and delete this itself. So let me just put where name equal to John. So just wait now. So two rows will be getting deleted. And just select the table now. So I'm having just a unique value, one value. So that's unique as well. So now let me just run this alter table syntax. So this time I'm getting a green mark because there isn't any null and there isn't any duplicate. So this syntax has been successfully executed. And now let's just insert some values. So we put insert into my table one values, and we put 1, John. Okay, so this will be getting inserted perfectly. So this my table now. So what if I like try to insert this again, okay? So let me just try to insert this again, and this time we will be getting an error, duplicate entry, so it won't be getting inserted. So this is how you add a primary key constraint to an existing column in SQL. And mine is a program channel. I've done many videos in SQL queries as well as interview questions, as well as programming videos in C, C++, Java, Python, as well as 3D animation in Blender. So do check out the videos of my channel. Subscribe and support me. Thanks for watching.